Hi, my name is Taylor. I'm the secretary here at Virginia Institute of Neuropsychiatry. I am who you see when you first walk in. I greet you, I take your height and weight, I get you all checked in, get all of your new patient forms, and then I take everything back to our clinical assistant.
Hi, I'm Nikki. I'm the business manager here at the Virginia Institute of Neuropsychiatry. You can contact me with any billing inquiries you may have.
Hello, my name is John. I'm the clinical coordinator. I help Dr. Ross and his system with getting brain MRIs for our patients. The reason we get brain MRIs is to run special software that analyzes their brain volumes. And so part of my job is to schedule the brain MRI for the patient at a specific MRI center near where they live. And it's very important that certain scanner settings have to be set exactly correct in order for this brain volume software to work correctly. And so I would go ahead and schedule that for the patient. And then after the MRI is done at their local MRI center, we would get the MRI disc sent back to our office. And then we would get the MRI. I'll check to make sure that it was done correctly. And once I do that and everything's correct, we send it off to get it neuroquanted at a company called Cortex Labs, which makes the neuroquant software. So I can show you here, this is what you'd get back when we get the MRI done. So this is what a patient's MRI would look like. Through the cloud, we can send it off to Cortex Labs servers, and then we get something like this back. This measures all the different brain volumes for all the regions. And one thing it does that's really cool is it compares each brain region to normal controls that are age and sex matched. And this allows you to tell if a brain region is abnormally large or abnormally small, which is very useful for various brain diseases, especially traumatic brain injury. And so with this, you can get objective evidence that there's something going on with their brain, which is extremely valuable for patients to know that something is actually going on. And it's not just in their head. So I do a lot of that here, help with the research for NeuroQuant. And we also have our own software called NeuroGauge, which is built on top of NeuroQuant. And it adds additional statistical analyses, you know, it tells you more about what's going on with your brain. Other than that, I help out with a little bit of the IT stuff here. And that's just about what I do here.
Welcome. I'm Jan Seba, Assistant Director, and I help Dr. Ross with all patient evaluations. For your evaluation, we ask that you bring a spouse, family member, or someone who knew you well before your illness or injury. We'll start by going over your current medications. Then I'll ask you about your past medical history, your illness or injury, and your current symptoms. I'll also administer a basic mental status exam. We usually take a break around 10:30, but if you need additional breaks, just ask. We normally finish the morning portion of the evaluation around noon. Then you'll be given at least an hour for lunch. When you return from your lunch break, you'll see Dr. Ross. I look forward to working with you.
Hi, I'm Dr. David Ross, and I'm a neuropsychiatrist here at the Virginia Institute of Neuropsychiatry. A neuropsychiatrist is a doctor that works in the area in between neurology and psychiatry. I treat patients with traumatic brain injury, mold-related illness, which can affect the brain, and other brain disorders. And I wanted to tell you a little bit about what we do clinically, especially an initial clinical evaluation, and mention a couple other things that we do here. For an initial clinical evaluation, you'll come in the morning and you'll see Ms. Seabaugh, who's our assistant director, and you'll be interviewed with her all morning and do a little bit of cognitive testing. Then you go have a lunch break. In the afternoon, you come and see me. I'll interview you, and usually you'll have a spouse or someone who knows you well to join you. Then we go across the hall and I'll do a physical exam, which includes things like watching you walk back and forth. I'll shine a light in your eyes and look at your pupillary reflexes. I'll check your reflexes with the reflex hammer, some simple things like that. And then at the end of the day, we come back here and I talk about your diagnoses and treatment plan. And usually by the end of the afternoon, we have, you know, a page or page and a half of ideas to help you that can reduce your symptoms. We also do other types of work here. We do MRI brain volume measurement is an important part of what we do. We use software called Neuroquant, which is FDA cleared software for measuring MRI brain volume. And our clinical coordinator, John Seabaugh, will help you get the brain MRI at an MRI center near you. Then we get the images sent to us. He'll do the frontline work on the MRI brain volume measurement. And then part of that, it'll create a report that looks like this, which has your MRI brain volume images with the Neuroquant has identified brain subregions and colored them. And this is the name, on this report here, the name of the subregions, the volume, and then the volume compared to a normal control group, which tells you if the brain volume regions are abnormally big or abnormally small or normal volume. And with a lot of our patients, let's say chronic mild traumatic brain injury, unfortunately, most of our patients have multiple brain volume abnormalities, which is concerning clinically. But it's not surprising because I've seen it so many times now. And but there is a good aspect to that in that it provides objective evidence of injury. Objective means you can't fake it or exaggerate it. So if someone, wasn't sure if you really had all the symptoms you said you had, when you do the MRI brain volume analysis, they can see, yes, there's a lot abnormal with your brain, and it helps other people know that you're telling the truth in many situations. Another thing we do here is research on MRI brain volume measurement. We published about 13 papers, peer-reviewed papers in the field over the last 10 years or so. And we have students coming through, college students and medical students, who might spend a month or a summer with us doing all the things we do here. So those are just some of the highlights of what we do here at the Virginia Institute of Neuropsychiatry.